So who wants to hear a story?
Me!
Okay!
Oh, cool!
Okay. Well, today's Hello Music Land story begins early one morning while Mr. Semibreve was on his morning walk. He was walking slowly as usual, counting to four each time he stepped.
Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Hello, Betty. One, two, three, four. Ouch!
Whoops! Hello, Mr. Semibreve. I didn't see you there.
Are you always in such a rush?
Yes, actually I am. You know, that's just me. I'm Mr. Crotchet and I'm so fast when I'm in a race. I don't come last.
I know, but... do you ever slow down to smell the flowers?
I can smell the fragrance of the flowers as I run past, actually. Hey, say, how about a race?
You're always wanting to race someone. You know you're going to win. I think you're faster than anyone in Hello Music Land that I know of. Especially me. I'm the slowest note in this land.
I know, but you'd at least come second. I've got an idea. Let's make it a really long race, a bit like the marathon in the Olympics.
Well, I guess we can. It's good exercise for me whether I win or come second, as you say. But speed is really not my forte. I'm supposed to be slow. That's the way I am.
Remember, Mr. Semibreve and Mr. Crotchet, up the garden path. Over the bridge, around the apple tree, then back here, in front of my house to finish. And so they were off. As expected, Mr. Crotchet shot ahead. Bye!
Leaving Mr. Semibreve to walk slowly, counting to four.
Here's the bridge. Oh, I'm so fast. When I'm in a race, I never come last. Yum. Big, red, juicy apples. I've got to have some. Mr. Semibreve is still so far away. He looks like a little speck in the distance. I'm sure I can take the time to eat some of these apples.
Oh, I've got such a tummy ache. I just need to lie down for a bit and rest. I'm sure Mr. Semibreve is still a long, long way away.
Mr. Semibreve finally reached the bridge, slow and steady, counting one, two, three, four as he went.
Imagine Mr. Semibreve's surprise when he approached the apple tree to find Mr. Crotchet holding his big, full belly and having a snooze under the apple tree.
Oh dear, poor Mr. Crotchet looks like he's eaten a few too many apples. I bet he didn't even stop running to eat them. I'm sure a little sleep will do him good. One, two, three, four... one, two, three, four.
So Mr. Semibreve went on his slow, steady way and eventually saw Vinnie Violin's house and the finish line not too far away.
One, two, three, four. Hello, Vinnie Violin. One, two, three, four.
Mr. Semibreve, what a splendiferous surprise. You're the winner of the race.
Hang on a minute. I'm here. How did you get here before me, Mr. Semibreve? I'm sure I just closed my eyes for a little moment under that apple tree. Oh, my tummy was so full.
Vinnie and Mr. Semibreve started laughing. You must have fallen asleep longer than you think.
Oh, I guess so. Oh, well, I can't believe it, Mr. Semibreve, but you actually did beat me in today's race.
Congratulations.
Why, thank you. Here, have an apple.
Funny at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, very funny.